Hey, welcome back. Last time we buffed up the Duff Bot, and now we're gonna pick up the treasure I saw on the way back. And of course, naturally, we're gonna fight garbage. Actually, I just realized there are three different colors. They have the red, yellow, blue. My girlfriend and I got into, I don't even want to say an argument, because we don't, we actually don't really argue. It's pretty nice. Usually if we have a disagreement, one of us may sound irritated, but we'll still talk about it. Like, we'll talk through it, which is really fantastic. It's one of the best parts about her, is you can actually talk to her about stuff. And vice versa, I mean, she can talk to me and I don't have to get upset to get my point across. So it's really good. But one of the things we were discussing is primary colors. Ooh, boogie! I thought the primary colors were like, why'd I get two swords? Unless that's for Rash. I thought the primary colors were red, green, blue. Cause like that's what they change the, like the component cables to, were those three colors, I think. Yeah, I get, ooh, magic, what? That's so good. Yes. Which means you can take this off. You know, honestly, the crits, this actually requires testing. The Masamune might still be better with the hero metal, because the crit rate seems over 50% with that. It might just be 50 or something like that, but he seems to really hammer people with that thing, so we'll just leave it for now. Watch, I'm gonna use him again. I'm gonna forget to change the hero metal. I have a wasted accessory slot. Damn it. Yeah, and she said they were red, yellow, blue. Because you can make every color out of that. I think she ended up being right. I think she looked it up and that's what it was supposed to be. There's something that bothered me that I read or something recently. Oh, I was... Okay, Maximilian. I talked about him before. He's one of my favorite YouTube internet people. I met him at E3 3 years ago. The one time I got to go, he was just randomly walking around in the Xbox section. And the friends I was with, you're like, oh my gosh, hey, what's up, Max? And we're like, oh, we're fans of yours. And he's all, oh, do you want a picture? And he just like offered us a picture, and he tried to get his friends with him that are part of his channel. He tried to get them in on it, but they were busy. So we took a picture with him, which I should flash on the screen. And then we, Okay, so he streams a lot now. And he's got a really good stream. If you've ever watched it, on YouTube he's Miles923. You can just type in Maximilian, he'll pop up. And on Twitch he's Maximilian Dude, but Dude is spelled D-O-O-D. And right now he's playing Dark Souls, like the first Dark Souls. It's his first time through it. He's doing pretty well, but I mean he played Bloodborne first, so he kind of understands the Souls game. Like how they're supposed to go, even though Bloodborne's not the exact same as Dark Souls, obviously, but you know, the goals and how the combat ideally works are not foreign to him, is my point. But he's doing really well so far. But his chat is pissing me off to no end. I forgot which way we're supposed to go. Oh, what? Oh. Okay, when we came that way, and we hit the switch, it took away this bridge. Shockwave. Who gets Shockwave? Isla? No. Probably Luca. Yeah. Oh, what? Getting some cool weapons, dude. I like weapons that have effects. Because it adds an element of strategy. It's not just, I do more damage. You know, like, Rash's sword having plus 4 magic. And I'm coming this way because we went the other way last time, and it blocked us off, so maybe this will open a path the other way, you know? I guess not, huh? Huh? This is weird. Yeah, he's playing Dark Souls, he's doing really well. His chat is backseat gaming the fuck out of him about it. Which can't really be helped. But, like, it's really annoying. is because there are things... There are things, like... He'll ask for help sometimes. He's like, guys, am I going the right way? Am I supposed to be going this way? And it's like, that's fine. You can do that. But there are people who are going, no, do this, because then this will happen. It's like, you're spoiling the game. The whole point of watching a blind run, which I know goes for Chrono Trigger as well, the whole point of that is to watch how someone deals with it the first time. So I guess we're going to go out the other way. And there's some very, I guess, Dark Souls 1 spoilers. I'll flag that. But there's, I mean, if you haven't played Dark Souls yet, I'm surprised. Or like, if you played it and cared, you would have played it by now. Yeah, so he... The example I'm using is Sif. You assholes. I don't know what this guy is. Yeah, with Sif, he, in the DLC... Well, you fight Sif normally. Sif's the giant wolf. And he just attacks you, and it's nothing. And then when you do the DLC area, you can use Sif as an ally. And then, if you use him as an ally... If you do the DLC first and use Sif as an ally, and then go back and fight Sif as a boss, you have a different cutscene. And that's cool. That's a nice little touch. Because everyone felt bad about killing Sif the first time, because Sif limps around, gets really weak when he's about to die and stuff like that, and it's really sad. And so... That guy got smashed, by the way. What ends up happening is... His whole chat was telling him, oh, do the DLC first, and then fight Sif after. And I was really annoyed, because what makes that scene so much better is if you fight Sif first, and then fight him again in another playthrough, and do the DLC first, like, because you get kind of the same reaction, like, oh my gosh, he was an ally. And then the scene that you get when you fight him as a boss is a lot more special. And I feel like his chat completely fucking ruined that, because they're making him do the DLC first and skip Sif as a boss, and it's really obnoxious. I don't like that. Like, you, when you play a Dark Souls game, you should, what is it, you should get the experience first. Like, when you ruin the experience, you just ruin the whole point of the game. So, I don't know, I was pretty salty about that. And then we had some other guy, there were two people in there, who were talking shit about Dark Souls 2. And I will agree, Dark Souls 2 is a complete fucking train wreck of a game. As a standalone game, it's okay. As an action RPG thing, it's actually not bad. As a sequel to Dark Souls 1, it's shit. There are a lot of people that joke, you know, they call it the B-Team, because Miyazaki wasn't a part of it, which, you know, was a notable factor. But it's interesting, they have, like, the girl statues that are offering something. By the way, this is a nice-looking woman. And then, you have these buff-ass, what is it, these demon statues. I know, this is what I learned in my world history class, in Greek architecture, they really... The reason they're so defined and stuff like that is because they really valued the human body and, like, what it was capable of. They really... That's something they really, like, you know, prioritize as a society. Okay. Are you guys gonna fight us down here? Oh. Yeah, the, Let's see, I was talking about Dark Souls. And... Oh, Dark Souls 2. Oh, that's not good. So they need... Okay, that didn't do a lot of damage, though. So we need a group attack. Kill these fucking airbenders. Oh, shit! I didn't know they got that close. I should've used Max Cyclone. Multiple counterattack technique. Yeah, they're gonna keep... Okay, so I guess we have to single-target them. Here we go. Hopefully that gets them. Yeah! Very powerful attack. Can't be moved, though. Really dependent on that. So, in Dark Souls 2, a lot of things are wrong. I'm not even going to defend that. It's actually just not a great game. But it's still fun. And there were improvements. There were a lot of negatives. Like, they had some interesting improvements, like I feel like the weapon balancing was a little better on some of them, probably a lot of them. You got a lot more weapons, that was actually pretty fun. And they had some different movesets, like a lot of the swords had vertical slashes now, like one-handed vert hits by default, which wasn't super common. In, like, they were like almost up and down, or in like Dark Souls 1, a lot of the one-handed weapons actually like did a complete like 45 degree cut. And that covered, like, high and low, so they were really strong. Like, a lot of the movesets in Dark Souls 1 were strong. Oh. Does that do damage? That doesn't do damage, it looks like. Yeah, the really annoying part, though. Is that actually hurting me? That is hurting me. Or it's hurting Chrono, I can't even tell. So I guess they want you to, like, hurry through here. But with Dark Souls 2, it was interesting having like four ring slots that allowed a lot of customization, but they made the rings individually weaker as kind of a result. You know, there wasn't like a ring of favor and protection. Well, actually, there was the third dragon ring, so maybe there was. We should actually... I guess let's kill that one because it's one punch away from dying. Then we'll try and max Cyclone. It looks like they're coming in. So hopefully we'll be able to by the time he gets there. We can at least get two of them. No? Okay. Let's just do that. Oh, is this a triple tech? No, this is a chrono tech, and I wasn't even paying attention. Oh, that did shit. Do they have a counter stance? When they have the staff behind their back, is that a counter stance? That's actually pretty interesting. Huh. Let's see if he changes. He's not attacking right now. The only reason I attacked the other guy is because he attacked me. Maybe not. Maybe I'm just reading too much into things. Yeah, and like, dual wielding was a huge improvement in Dark Souls 2. In Dark Souls 1, there wasn't really dual wielding. Like, you could dual wield, but it was like, you used your... That actually does some good healing, too. You used your, weapons kind of individually, so like if you had a dual-wield weapon, you'd have like a spear in your offhand or like a scythe. Something with reach, so you like poke people down or something. Like that was actually something a few different people did, and I used to do it too in PvP. I'd have like a demon spear, which was a lightning-based spear, in my offhand. So if I got them low and they tried to like shield or something, I could just stab them through the shield with lightning damage. Good rock has been passed down through the ages. From it, a magic pendant and a knife were made. I have both now. We embody Melchior's dreams, sealed within the knife. Now hurry, if you plan to confront the Queen, we're counting on you. Thanks, Masa. I need a save point. I need a save point, damn it.
I can feel it! The pulse of eternal life! Ha ha ha! Dark force! Wild energy!
Sorry, sometimes you gotta get into the voices, because it's actually pretty fun.
The Mammon Machine! Your Majesty, it's too dangerous!
Mother!
Silence, you stupid servant! Don't stop, Shala! We're almost there! Immortality will be ours! Zeal will have the glory it deserves!
Wahaha!
Too long have I waited!
I don't have a good fake laugh, that's why I don't do it. That's why I try and make it, like, really sarcastic. My mom doesn't have a good singing voice, I don't think. So she always sings sarcastically, and I kind of, like, adopted that. So if you're not good at something, make it as sarcastic as possible so it's actually... you attempt it to be funny. Leave me alone. Aw, man. Ooh, save point. Come fight us on the wall if you dare! And I move around really quickly! You know what? I can't really do anything about that. You don't hit me too hard. With nearby brothers. Well, it says brother, so maybe that gets stronger if they have more than one of them together. You know, maybe you can have, like, one Bargus and a bunch of Jins. Yeah, you have to punch him one more time to break the shield. Yeah, with the... Okay, in Dark Souls 1, there's a stat called Resistance. Resistance was garbage. There's no point to using it. Like, they wanted to tie defense to a stat, so lightweight characters didn't have to stack armor to get good defenses, but it turned out to be garbage because the... I think it just scaled horribly. I can't remember what the exact reason was. And in Dark Souls 2, they had Adaptability, which was kind of a... It was the upgraded version of Resistance, but it did other things, like it made some items use faster, like especially your Estus Flask. And it gave you more iframes on your roll at certain breakpoints. So in turn for that, they nerfed the base roll. Like the base evasion roll had, I think, 8 iframes. And if you pumped your if you got your agility, which was tied to your adaptability stat and your attunement stat, if you got that to 100, you had 12 iframes, which is half of your roll, because... Well, around half, because your roll is, I think, 25 frames of animation. There's a huge thread on it, on, like, the Dark Souls 2 subreddit, so they did really well. Someone got a lot of info out, and I was very appreciative of that. And so, I should have used a tent, actually. I wasn't thinking. And so not that we really need it. Everyone's got, like, a lot of MP. This group doesn't use MP. The more I'm using this group, it's starting to grow on me. Like, I kind of like it. I like being able to just press the fight button and stuff dies, and... You know, their techs are getting stronger. It's like a really strong physical group. And so the reason I bring up... Well, let's back up a little bit. Dark Souls 2 also had Soul Memory. Soul Memory was the worst mechanic ever conceived in a Souls game. 10,000 hertz. Like, I can't get over how bad Soul Memory is. I don't know who... Whoever thought of that should have been fucking fired. And if you don't know what Soul Memory is, it's like... You know, like, how you gain XP in games? And how it shows you how much XP you've gotten over the life of your character? Like, it's even in this game. I'll show you in a sec. But they use that. Because you get souls every time you do stuff. Like, you kill enemies, and souls is... You use souls as XP and currency. And you couldn't group up with people who were outside of your soul memory range. It was really dumb when you got to, like, higher soul memory. And their workaround this, because you couldn't play with anyone, you couldn't invade anyone, you couldn't co-op at certain points, it was just really dumb. And so their way around this was to make it so... Okay, I guess we're going down. Was to... Alright, I have to fight on this. I'm gonna prioritize the Jin. Yeah, I was really hoping to get him first, but it looks like he's gonna get his combo off. Okay. Yeah, and their way to get around that is they introduced a ring that stopped your soul memory from going up, but it was just like, remove the mechanic, don't, like, you have to waste a ring slot now to get around it. It's like, no, just, it's a shit mechanic, get rid of it. And so a lot of people joked and called Dark Souls 2 the B team, or whatever. And the reason I bring that up is because in Max's chat during Dark Souls, because he's playing through Dark Souls 1, I brought that up. Because people were talking about, I was like, well, Dark Souls 2 had a lot of mechanical improvements that were pretty nice. And some guy immediately said, oh, what the fuck? I don't like the double confusion, that's actually pretty scary. Can't really do much about it. Well, they're attacking the right characters, at least. If this counts as a physical, this should break it on both of them. I think it did, actually. Because it took Isla's turn. Yeah. And then it confused him. Does that have a random chance to confuse and it just never went off for me? Why do you hit her, but you don't hit the enemies? Yeah, so... when the subject came up in Max's chat, I said that Dark Souls 2 did have some improvements, which were pretty nice. It had some, like, graphical improvements, too. Like, a lot of the armors had cloaks that moved around a lot. Like, there were some improvements. I can't knock it. But this guy... I got two responses. One of them was... Some guy said, "Well, Soul Memory's complete shit. You can't deny that." And I said, "I never mentioned Soul Memory." And he's like, "Well, you need to specify." And that just goes, again, to show you the ignorance of fucking people on the internet, where they just want to pick a fight, and they don't read what you fucking say, and they try and make a big deal out of it, like, they're so eager to try and, like, pin you, like, "Oh, you don't know what the fuck you're talking about!" And that actually looks pretty cool. It's a long animation, but it looks cool. And so you, and then someone else said to me, like, "Oh, I'm sorry, but adaptability's a shit stat." Okay, do that counterattack. I don't get confused when you do that. And I told him... And again, I never mentioned adaptability. He's like, "Well, adaptability is a garbage stat. And it forces you to get it just to play the game." And I said, "You don't have to get adaptability to play the game." I didn't say this part, but my Dark Souls 2 playthrough... I got, like, a couple points of agility. I don't even think I hit a proper breakpoint for my roll speed. I went through the entire vanilla game and two DLCs and maybe a third DLC without pumping my adaptability. So I had a shit roll for the entire game, and the entire game I was bitching about how garbage the roll was. You're not forced to get it, but it does help. But then it's also like, what they also don't understand is you can say, okay, let's get that. It's like, well, it didn't do a lot of damage, but I got a double kill, so that's pretty nice. I mean, yes, it helps you get combo attacks, we gotta break these up. Yeah, I was gonna say, it looks like it does some damage. There we go. Good job, Chrono. So the... But the other thing is, like, people don't think of all their options. You know, it's like, oh, you have to get adaptability so you can have a good roll, so you can play the game normally. It's like, you don't have to. What if you make a heavy armor character with a great shield? You don't roll. You tank stuff. You don't roll, though. You rarely roll when you have heavy armor. Unless you're really fucking good at iframing through attacks. You normally don't roll when you have super heavy armor because you get a fat roll, and your roll is slow as hell, and there's no point. So it's like, there's another example where you don't need adaptability, and it's just dumb. You know, if you play like a super mage that never goes into physical combat, you don't have to roll through shit. You just pop items and you keep bombing your spells all the time. It's like, those are two examples immediately I can think of where you don't need roll speed or iframes. It's just... It was dumb. And he was saying, like, oh, adaptability is a shit stat, you need it. It's like, no, you don't. Plus, adaptability, they tied other things to it to make it good because it was such shit in Dark Souls 1. So it wasn't a bad thing to try. It didn't work out well, but it still, like, they tried something. They really tried to improve something that was complete garbage. You have to give them that credit. But instead, it was like, no, man, Dark Souls 2 is complete garbage. There's nothing good about it. Like, gosh, you guys are... Dark Souls 1 had some problems. We really can't ignore that fact. Dark Souls 1 had some problems. Doesn't mean that's not probably my favorite game ever, and in my opinion, one of the greatest games ever made. For a lot of reasons besides that. But it definitely had its flaws. I was irritated because people in chat were arguing with me about that shit. And I don't mind if someone argues with me. If they have, like, a well-educated opinion. Not that my opinion is always the best educated, I can't, you know, say something like that. But it's like, if you're gonna really argue with someone or start some shit, you really need to have an idea of what the fuck you're talking about. And it's like, you need to examine the... Oh, gosh. Oh, we should have maxed Cyclone. It's not good, we're gonna get triggered again. Unless she kills it. Yeah. Cool. Nope, JK. Not enough damage. Hopefully they stay together and I can max cyclone them. Come on, you bastards! Alright, fine. It's kind of a waste, but whatever. Well, it's not really a waste. I mean, he killed some stuff. Yeah, it's like, I was going on about that when I was on my little political tirade. People just don't... They don't read the counter-arguments or, like, the other sides of all the coins and stuff like that. They just... They pick a side and just go, this is my side and this is what I'm doing. It's like, you can pick a side, but at least examine the other side so you can see why your side is good or where it's wrong or something like that. It's just really dumb. There's people who don't... People just don't examine everything. It's really sad. But enough about that. We're having fun playing some Chrono Triggers. I guess we're gonna press the switch. I have an almost 2-pound box of goldfish sitting next to me. I've gone through most of it. I've had it for a week now. And goldfish are delicious. They're so deliciously salty. That's the only reason I like them. I hate cheese. But these things are so fucking salty. I just love the salt. It's pretty funny. Yes! No! No! Oh well. So it's nice though, because I can just open the box, get like two handfuls, snack on it slowly. That's what I've been doing. It's... Here, let's see if you guys... So I hit the mic by accident. See? We got the... we got goldfish. We're ready. We got childhood snacks. Even though I'm in my late 20s. They're so fucking good, though. I can't get over it. Okay, so we're... Okay, so the HP thing's really working out for him, because it seems like he's always missing, like, 300 life or something. Like, his... He just gets... What are his stats looking like? Does he really just get hammered? 58, 57, 43... His physical defense is okay. His magic defense is shit. Magic defense is the lowest. By far! It's actually really good. He has a lot of HP, so he can soak. Can we... Do you have a magic defense item? No. That sucks. So actually, the HP is really good for him, I feel like. Especially because he's our healer. If he has to stay alive and stuff, that would be good. I was going to say, is there a puzzle that I screwed up by not getting the other switches? Oh, it goes underground? Ew. Scary. Run! Run! Oh, yes. Let's get the chest first. Elixir, thank goodness, no mimics. Oops. And let's use our shelter. You know, just use a bunch of items. But I want the full MPs, guys. The full MPs. So, this looks like a boss door. I guess we'll do the boss fight on camera. Have a bit of a longer episode today. I guess, since everyone seems to like that, so... Or, when I say everyone, I mean like three people so far. Hopefully, my internet doesn't fucking act up when I'm uploading. Dalton! You made it this far. Maybe I underestimated you. But this is the end. They will take care of you. Come, Golem twins! I have the wrong group for this shit. If they have the same mechanic as... If they have the same mechanic as the other one, I'm so fucked. At least they're focus firing. Shit. And we're a little tougher now, though. So that shit doesn't hurt us. Just spam heal. There we go. So they'll counterattack immediately with it. I really don't like this boss. It's a good boss, though. It's just, it's kind of scary, because I feel like I need to get all this shit under control. I'm just gonna blow them up together. Yeah. I mean, we have so much more physical defense now, though. Maybe it's actually a viable strategy to let them physically attack us. We'll test it. Like, this is so much easier. They just spam a group attack that I can heal through. So we'll see. We'll test out the physical. Plus, this way we'll kill them together. And I'm assuming since it's two of the same enemy, they're not gonna have a... what you call it? They're not gonna have... you know, maybe we can influence it. We can make one lightning and then just punch the hell out of the other one. This doesn't do a lot of damage. Like, this takes him out of the fight, almost. I think the physical hit was doing, like, 200 to a single target. I almost want to put speed on him. Just because... if, like, I want my healers to be fast. Like, I want to put speed on Rash, I want to put speed on Mango, I want to put speed on Marley now. So I want all my healers to be quick. Yeah, still does a lot of damage. Shit! Oh, crap. Mashed A too quick. It's like, that's real bad. I don't think we're bone, but... it's pretty scary right now. Damn it. At least they're attacking Chrono. Chrono's got like... okay, that's fine. Oh yeah. We definitely want to keep these lightning. I mean, I can handle one being physical. Plus, Chrono's magic is doing more damage than his melee to two targets. But it does save MP. This, let's just keep doing this. Yeah, if they're the same enemy as before, they should have the same amount of HP. And we're a lot stronger than we were the first time we fought these, so they should go down quicker. That's the hope. They seem to be doing about the same damage. They have the same... what is it? The same mechanic. I'm actually gonna hold on to this. We're gonna do the strat we were doing before. Just keep them, keep them as physicals. Or keep them as lightnings. I always wonder what these games would look like in modern graphics. They have some interesting looking characters. Nope. Heal up. That's the other thing. Now our group has enough healing to actually survive this shit. I mean, before we had Rash just spamming group heals. Wasn't too bad. We're kind of doing the same thing, but since there are two of them, the damage output pretty much doubles, basically. Like, it doubles, but you're stronger, so it kind of evens out. It's kind of in the middle, but it's always getting caught. This isn't a Nancy Drew mystery, just Keenan and Kel on your TV. Whatever happened to Coolio? He just went away. This fight's taking a while, just because the animations on all this shit is so long. You have to keep using abilities, and all the ability animations are much longer than just, like, a sword cut. I'm actually gonna use a barrier here. Because he's getting pretty low. Like, just him taking all this extra damage is starting to add up. Because, you know, he's taking 60 more than Chrono, 30 more than Isla. Lightning. This will hold Isla's attack. I mean, it's going really slow right now. But when they go down, they're gonna go down together. So it really does matter. Damn, he was ready with that attack. Holy sh! As soon as he got it, he's like, yep, blah. I feel like the physical is the worst way to do this fight. Just because they keep doing the Iron Ball, which is kind of hard to consistently heal through. Even though it's good if you have Marley, actually. Like, if there's one of them and you have Marley, it's good. Because they, because it's single target, so you can just, like, drop heals and stuff like that. But my group right now is set up to group heal, so. That's why it's helpful. I guess he just counterattacks with that shit immediately. So he can't drop the physical in between, probably. You fucking steal? Can you steal from this dude, please? What?! I was afraid of that. Oh, it's bullshit. We'll try and steal from the last one. See if we get anything. I'm hoping it's not like Final Fantasy IX where... And Final Fantasy VI. And Final Fantasy Tactics, where stealing gets you some good shit. Seems to be a thing with these guys. Guess let's heal him. He's got the most HP. He's missing some. Animations! Reminds me of Hearthstone, everyone! Get in here! Alright, so I made a mistake putting the boss fight on camera, because now we're at it's taking 10 minutes almost. It's probably gonna take 10 minutes. I wish I could slow them, or something. Probably should have attacked with Isla. That's not a big deal. Oh, barrier's gone. Shut up, dog! I used the barrier on the wrong person. Oh, that's probably the bad thing about killing them together. Oh, shit. Okay, we're good. I mean, she's lower. So I guess it's not bad. Let's get topped off. Oh! Sweet! We gotta heal up too, because he uses Dalton shit. Anything else? Can you tell me nothing left to steal? Funny. Ow! Kill him! That should do it. What? He really took that much more damage? Like, the other one really took that much more damage. That's interesting. Thanks. Blaze it. Oh, combos. Damn, he... Mango just got comboed for like 700 fucking damage. Money. Uzi Punch. Beast Toss. Tex. They beat the Golem Twins. Alright, this calls for the Golem Boss. I don't... What's the strange force? Could this be Lavos's energy? I don't want to fight the Golem Boss, dude. Got a bad feeling about this. All my work will be in vain if I expire before I'm immortal. Leave so I can save. This is your lucky day. Bye-bye. Bye, Dalton. We're gonna save, and then we're gonna stop. We're gonna save here. We're gonna use this item. Thanks for watching. Next time, we are going to see what the hell is going on with the Lavos thing. And I will see you guys later. Is 900... Is 1,000... Ah, is 1,000 HP the max? Oops. That would suck.